There also appears to be a problem, at least from Sean Spicer's point of view, with asking the president questions and getting real answers. So then Sean Spicer goes to the podium with the press, and he can't confirm or comment on the questions that the press has about Jared Kushner and whether or not Jared Kushner tried to set up this back channel. So, I mean, at what point, why is Sean Spicer holding these press briefings? You know, what's the point of these?
There's really no point. And what's unfortunate for Sean Spicer is that the White House press secretary position under President Trump doesn't have credibility. And so, you know, I've been in this job. I've had interactions with press secretaries. I have a certain amount of sympathy for Sean Spicer because, you know, he's got to do what his boss wants him to do. His boss has not been truthful with the American people, nor have people who have worked for President Trump. And as long as that's the case, the White House doesn't have credibility. You don't know what to believe. And so you're just on the receiving end of a rant. And that's not information. It's argument. It's not helpful. And it's all it's doing is trying to foster divisions and create a lot of just create a lot of noise. I mean, the bottom line is we have an investigation here that's running on several tracks. It's a serious investigation. You have a president without discipline. You have a president who is going to have a very hard time getting back to an actual agenda. Apparently, I've heard conservative commentators in the past few days say, I don't know, this is all about jobs. Great, let's talk about jobs. Where are the jobs? Where's economic growth? Where are some of the things that the stock market was so excited about? Because you only have so much political capital. This president doesn't realize that. He's squandering it because he is allowing himself to be dragged into something that he cannot control. But he thinks he still can.
Okay, panel, thank you very much.